What is up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to the channel. Today is the day. It's my first ever Call of Duty Vanguard official gameplay commentary. You know, I talked about Vanguard for months now, but this is the first time you're seeing Vanguard on your screen, and unfortunately, it's not that good. It's not that good a gameplay. All right, let me be specific here. It's not that good of a gameplay. I played for, 4 hours or so. No, that's too long. Maybe like 3 hours. Pretty much right when the beta came live. I think it was like 11:30 or something, like a little bit earlier. It was supposed to come out at 1. So I basically played for a couple hours there. And unfortunately, I'm not going to say this is the best gameplay I could get, but this is the most accurate gameplay I could get. It is chaotic, all right? A lot of things, it's not the most smooth game, okay? A lot of things go wrong in this gameplay. A lot of shots are missed. A lot of rage happens. It's not my best gameplay, you know, nowhere near my best gameplay. I think I get like a 1 KD. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I don't do well in this gameplay. I die a lot. I die to a lot of stupid stuff. I die to a lot of better players, you know? It's a little sweaty out here, you know? It is, you know, Vanguard, it's a new beta, it's a new game. There's gonna be sweats, especially this early on. Yeah, people, like, if you're hopping on before the, you know, servers are quote unquote supposed to be up, yeah, you're gonna face some good people, okay? It's just kind of expected at this point. I get a few clips here and there, some good feeds and whatnot, but sometimes, man, it's just spawn die. Yeah, it is not super enjoyable right now. And that leads me to my very first thing I want to talk about. Let's talk about the pros and cons of the Vanguard beta so far. Before I get into it, if you enjoy the video, if at any point, if you enjoy the gameplay, even though it's, you know, painfully average, go ahead and leave a like, subscribe if you're new to the channel, and let's talk about the good things first. All right, let's start positive with Vanguard. It's a new year, new game, let's start positive. Okay, so the very first thing I want to talk about is the time to kill. This is something that's kind of overlooked. I don't think armor needs to be in this game, okay? I saw that the armor field upgrade is switched from, you know, it used to be a fast recharging, now it's slow. That's a good change. I don't think we need that at all, okay? The time to kill feels pretty okay in this game. From snipers, from ARs, you know, I tried out even shotguns, LMGs. It feels okay. You know, I'm sure, you know, some guns are probably going to be more broken and busted than others. Obviously, certain attachments are going to change things as well, like if you're shooting through walls or whatever. But in general, okay, time to kill doesn't need to change. I think it's perfectly fine. I think it is good, okay? The second pro is the maps. They're not awful and they're not amazing. I think they're playable though, you know, and that's kind of all I'm needing from a beta. When I played Azure Cave, you know, forget it, okay? Forget it. I'm not playing, you know, like never again. The player count was totally off and all that stuff. Just no. I have played 6v6 Red Star at this point. I think I've played all the maps. They're relatively okay, you know? I think they're very vibrant. The flow's not great for some of the player sizes. I'll talk about that in my con section and probably throughout the year. Honestly, the pacing just doesn't feel great all the time, but when it feels good, or like when it's actually properly set, like the amount of players or how many are supposed to be on the map, I think you're in for a good game, all right? And that's actually my last point. The pacing is usually good so far to me, all right? Like, I've played, like I said, for like 2.5-3 hours. I haven't come across that many games where it feels like I'm running around forever and not finding anyone. Usually it's the case of like there's too many people and they're spawning in my butthole, you know, before I can even turn around. It's usually that, which is a better problem to have, in my opinion, than running around for 2 hours and finding one person. That's just my opinion. You know, obviously both are bad, but if you're gonna have messed up pacing, I'd prefer it be a little more on the faster side than the slower side. Sadly enough, you know, I mean, like, I could talk about a few other pros, like some small ones. Like, I think the movement's fine. I think it hasn't been super glitchy. I don't know if that's a pro. It's kind of just to be expected when you pre-order a game at this point, but I guess you could always use the beta excuse. Like I said, the movement's fine. It's very, very reminiscent of Modern Warfare. So if you like that engine, if you like that movement, you're going to like this. I personally do. You know, I can't believe I'm saying it, but I do like that aspect of Modern Warfare. Because the engine is smooth, not drop shotting. The drop shotting's actually not in the game. You know, sliding around, mounting even, you know, it all feels very familiar. It doesn't feel like you're learning or playing a brand new game. So I like that, but it's not really a big enough thing to be like, oh, this is a good thing about the game. It's kind of just, okay, we should expect this, right? So that is basically going to do it for the pros. Let's talk about some cons real quickly, or I guess not quickly, because most of the video is going to be cons, unfortunately, from here on out. Number one, biggest con by far, the spawns, okay? They are so messed up. Like I said before, people spawn in each other's buttholes. I've spawned with teammates and enemies within breathing distance of each other. Every time I die, I sometimes spawn right in like the exact same spot and get shot again by the same person. You literally see in the kill feed before anything happens, I get killed by the same guy twice. It is wild. I don't think you see it in this gameplay, but there's some gameplays, dude, it's completely wild. I've never seen spawns this broken before. I'm honestly not sure if it's because of like the pacing where they have like too many players on the map. Maybe it is they just didn't test it or whatever. I don't know. Maybe it's probably hard, right? Because you have 6v6, 8v8, 10v10, 12v12. Like there's so many different player counts for different maps. It's probably hard. I'm going to cut them a little slack because of the beta. I do think that they will fix a majority of them. I don't think it'll be flawless. You know, I don't think it'll be perfectly A-OK baby skin smooth at launch. I doubt that. It would be nice, but it is Call of Duty, and you know they do take their time with, you know, fixing things. Let's look at Warzone here, for example. But if I was them, the very, very first thing I would fix is the spawns in this game, okay? Respawn is not that fun when you get spawn killed and can't feel like you can move, right? Next up, the sun, all right? And going along with it, the visibility, but let's talk about the sun first, especially on this map, dude. And that's kind of partly why I picked this map. Dude, the sun is glaringly bright, way too bright, to the point where it's like obnoxious. Like when you like step outside, for instance, in real life and you see the sun, it's kind of like that. It's why do I need to see that in a video game? You know, I'm playing video games to not go outside. And so are, you know, a lot of you losers, honestly. That's kind of what it is. I don't want to deal with the sun. All right. Gamers don't like the sun. I don't like the sun being this bright. You can have the sun, just don't make it blinding. I actually don't know what the developers were thinking. Maybe they thought like, oh, this is a cool addition. People are really going to like this. Maybe it looks cool, but it plays terribly, because if you get shot by someone and you couldn't see them, that, guess what? That feels terrible. And that kind of goes along with visibility in general. People are like in dark corners a lot. There's a lot of dark corners. Maybe it's the Nvidia. I need some filters or whatever. Keep in mind, this is the beta. There's no Nvidia filters. There's no like color contrasting or whatever. I'm probably going to do some tweaking to the color correction in the editing software that I'm using, but keep in mind that it's not going to be super saturated. It's not going to be super bright and vibrant. It's not bad, you know, especially compared to a lot of other previous Call of Duty games, but it, by no means is it, oh, people stand out super easily. I can see everyone. No, it's not a game like that. Next up is a small one, the SND, because I played one match of Search and Destroy. The timer seems to be bugged. It seems like you can hear enemy, you know, voices as well. It just seems like things are kind of not balanced, not tweaked, not checked. You know, they didn't check their work pretty much when it comes to Search and Destroy. I don't really get that. I think that needs to be fixed, and they should definitely do something about that. I think they will, you know, like I said, it's a beta. I'm pretty sure they'll get around to that at some point. Another huge, ginormous gripe of the beta, the leveling up system. Why do we need to level up in a beta when they're going to take it away from us when the full game launches? Just if it's a beta, you know, I get it, maybe the first day or something like that, you know, just test it out, the servers or whatever, so you just give us, you know, random default classes or whatever, it's hard to level up. But by day two or day three of the beta, just give us everything, dude. Just give us everything that we can possibly unlock, everything that we can possibly use, and let's just try it out, you know? That way you get more data too as a development studio. You get more data to be like, oh, hey, the dogs might be broken. The dogs might be too easy to get. Or, hey, this gun has no recoil, you know? But we're not going to know these things because it takes us 5.5 years to unlock the one weapon. We're not going to know this. We're not going to play test this. And then when it happens in real life, in the real game, guess what? You guys are going to be screwed because people are going to be big mad at you. And this could have been avoided if you just gave us this in the beta. So like, listen to my videos, subscribe, guys. If you're watching the Sledgehammer Games, you better subscribe to my channel. But yeah. And the last thing I want to talk about, not going to make a huge issue about it, but skill-based matchmaking, it's engine or EOMM, engagement optimized matchmaking, whatever the case may be. It's in the game. It's pretty obvious. You know, the first couple of games I got, what, 3 KDs, 2 KDs, and shortly followed by 1 KD. So yeah, it definitely matches you up with people to challenge you. Not always a bad thing, not always a good thing, but sometimes it is annoying, you know? It's more fun going, you know, a 3 KD than a 1 KD. Just if you ask any COD player, I'm pretty sure they'll agree with you, but that's what it is. There's a lot of, you know, other feedback that I'm going to, you know, get my hands on and things like that. A lot of other modes to try, a lot of other guns to play with. But so far, initial impressions, it's not that bad of a game. You know, I'm not going to say it's the best COD ever. Definitely has a lot of issues. but it's not that bad. You know, as of right now, I'll probably give Vanguard probably a 6.5 or 7 out of 10. 10 out of 10 being like an all-time great classic Call of Duty, best COD ever or something. So it falls above average in my opinion, so that's good. And like I said, I think a lot of things in this game are good and should be good for, you know, the future. We'll have to see, of course, how they tune things, how they fix things. I do think Sledgehammer Games is a company, is a development studio that will listen to its feedback, listen to its consumer base. So hopefully they do. But anyway, make sure to leave a like, subscribe if you're new to the channel. Vanguard videos are popping up again. You know, you don't want to miss them. Hit that bell notification, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a great day, guys. Peace out.